6, a helping hand with your land.
Neil from Essex here to discuss some things about tractor cabs with you here today. I have a new Curtis Advantage cab to go on a Kubota BX series tractor. Gonna walk around here a little bit, show you some things about this cab, compare it to the OEM Kubota factory cab, maybe help you decide if one of these might be worth adding to your tractor. Here in the Northeast, tractor cabs are quite desirable. It gets cold here, particularly in the wintertime. If you're gonna be out doing any kind of snow removal and wanna be protected from the elements a little bit, a cab can help you do that. It's a lot more though than just about staying warm. While we can, you know, kind of enclose some heat inside of here to keep you warm, protection from the wind and from the snow that might be blowing off back of a snowblower is a really nice benefit of having an enclosure around you. When you watch guys out on a windy day running a snowblower, it can feel like half of that snow is ending right back up in your face again. So there's a lot of benefits here to having a cab for those purposes. You've heard me before when we're going through and talking about cabs on tractors that sometimes I will discourage cabs periodically. There is a price point here when it comes to cabs that if you're spending too little, you're doing absolutely nothing for the resale value of your tractor. Cabs that are purely canvas enclosures around a machine aren't made to fit it real well can actually hurt the resale value of your tractor in the long run. When you go around and you start drilling holes to put in bolts or you have ill-fitting pieces attached to your tractor, it hurts the resale value. It's not a nice fit for your machine that somebody in the secondary market is going to put some value to. There is a point though that you start to spend a little bit more money that you get into things that do add value to your tractor and fit the machine well and properly. And this is kind of the first cab that I would say does that well on a Kubota BX. So this is not the first cab that I've talked about on the BX series tractor. You'll notice in some other videos that I did a little while ago, another cab on this machine that's a Kubota OEM cab. Now both that cab and this one are actually manufactured by the same people. Curtis Industries up in Massachusetts is the OEM manufacturer of that cab for Kubota. It is kind of the high-end offering of a cab for a BX series machine. Curtis makes and sells this one themselves direct. They call it an Advantage Series cab. It's not quite as premium as what the Kubota one is, but equally equipped. It comes through about 30% less expensive, so it is meaningfully less money on a tractor in this price range where, say you could take a Kubota OEM cab, totally deck it out, so you have it installed, it can add as much as 50% onto the price of your tractor, where this one's gonna come through at a point that it might be a lot more economical than what that OEM one may be. You're gonna notice some similarities between them when we go around here. Things like these LED work lights up here on the top of the cab look shockingly the same between those two cabs, and it's because they are. They're coming out of the same factory, so there are some bits and pieces here that do overlap between the two models. So sitting in the cab here, there's a handful of things I would say are done fairly well and some things that are improved upon in the more deluxe version. So you can see here when I'm sitting in the machine, a BX is a fairly small tractor, and yet this is actually a fairly spacious cab. Sitting inside of here, the doors and stuff on the cab sit on a metal frame that sits on the outside edges of the platform. So you're not losing any, say, cab operator area by installing this. The doors are equally as far outside to the edge of the machine. The heater is tucked right in here inside the right-hand side. This is actually fairly nice compared to the OEM cab. With one issue though, the OEM has little doors down here by the bottom that allow you to pop those doors open and reach forward in order to hit the releases to take your loader off your tractor. This one though doesn't open up. There's some cost savings there, and this heater kind of occupies that area. So if you're gonna take the loader off, you've gotta get off the machine and reach, kind of wiggle your fingers around the outside in order to reach those loader locks to release them. The more deluxe Kubota cab is gonna have a nice switch bank up here that you have in order to do things like operate your wipers and your work lights. These are gonna have switches here kind of molded into their, drilled into this front piece across here. So your work lights are a very simple switch. Your rocker right here to turn your heater and your fan on and off are right here in the front. You can see that switch is probably the same one used in the Kubota one. Your wiper motors are right here, and you're literally flipping the switch on the wiper motor when you want to operate it. So gets the job done, but clearly a less expensive way of building a cab. We started off this video by saying there's a point where you get too cheap on the cab scale that you're not doing a whole lot for your machine. One of the areas where kind of tells you where this is done better. When it comes to air sealing and stuff, there is an actual kit that goes on this, like the OEM kit, that goes and covers off some of the areas on the tractor simply to keep air out of the cab. When you're in a machine and you look down underneath your seat, you typically see straight down to the ground, and some cheap cabs absolutely do nothing to try to keep the air out from coming right up and from underneath the seat. This one, though, you're going to notice panels to go across the radiator to kind of keep the heat out there, and brushes and stuff that are going to go around the pedals in order to do as much as possible to keep that cold air out of the cab. So what is one to do in the summertime once this thing has been put onto your tractor? Obviously, you probably don't want to drive around on a beautiful 72 degree day with sunny blue skies inside of this. So you do got some options. So the doors on this are going to come off very, very easy, easier than the Kubota OEM cab will. It's as easy as swinging the door open and then lifting it up off the hinges in order to remove it from the sides. For the front of the machine, you've got two big latches right down here in the bottom. You can push that front to kick out your windshield and get some air through there. And interestingly enough, the back window also opens up on this, which it does not actually on the Kubota OEM cab. You have an opening back window, so you can get a lot of easy front to back ventilation. And if you want to go through and lift your doors off, it's really trivial to do so. In order to have heat inside the cab, right here on the right hand side, I have a heater element. This is going to take hot water off the engine and bring it back here through a fan and a radiator in order to provide some heat in the cab. You've got a switch right up here on the dash that you could flip in order to toggle that on and off. In the summertime, interestingly enough, there's actually an air conditioning option for these now. And I have one of those coming, believe it or not. We'll be able to show it to you here in the future. But small cabs like this have never really had a good option for that in the past, but Curtis is now actually providing one to us. So you can take this cab or the more deluxe Kubota cab and install an air conditioner up on the roof that's driven electrically with a little bit larger alternator that needs to be put on the engine. So we'll be showing you that one in the future. So that's a little bit on the Curtis Advantage cab for the Kubota BX. Coming in at about 30% less expensive than the OEM Kubota cab does, this thing represents a pretty compelling value. Prices are always changing, but as of today, the beginning of 2020, you could pick one of these guys up, including the accessories, the heater kit, the work lights, the wiper, for just over $3,400. So it's a pretty economical way to get yourself out of the weather and provides a pretty compelling quality for what it is. I have been a little wishy-washy about some of these aftermarket cabs in the past, but we got to give props to Curtis. They go through and they address a lot of my objections one by one here over the years, and the quality of these things has definitely taken a step forward as years have gone by. So this is a piece that we can help you out with. We are a retailer for these guys. They've got a complete product line of a lot of different styles of cabs with different options and accessories for both Kubota and New Holland products, but a lot of other models that are out there on the marketplace as well. So if we can help you out, give us a call at Messix. We're available at 800-222-3373 or online at messix.com. We'll be right back.